they can apply this rule. I've been to the United States more than 15 times.
And it's the same person at the same position. Now they apply this interpretation, so it's basically a political position to avoid and make more difficult the engagement and the relations between the Cuban and the United States.
Tell me about
Cuban
participation last time.
No, well, in Barcelona, the Cuban participated at LAFA
and Congress President.
Hopefully, as we know, the next
LAFA Congress
will be outside of the United States, which gives us a better opportunity to participate. In Mexico than Canada, which by then I hope it's a better situation.
And then Colombia and maybe Portugal. So the next four congresses that will be announced
will also have United States.
And that would give us a better option for the debate.
So you're convinced that this arbitrary decision not to let you participate has to do with the current U.S. administration?
No, basically, not to let Cuban scholars participate. It has to do with the current policy of limited dialogue, aggressiveness, and a retrogression of the
of all
the policies
that
have run
in
place before this
administration
gets involved.
Thank you.
Mr. Lina, I'm better with that. We're speaking to some Cuban scholars who provide entry visas to the United States Congress. Ready to go, and the U.S. first saying they will reflect to U.S. national security.
On behalf of the government and people of Dominica, we're here to speak to the Cuban people. And in solidarity with the express and extend it to you, we shall continue to express the solidarity to the great people of the Cuban Revolution.
Prime Minister of Dominica, Lucifer Garrett.
We have the country to speak for the removal of this unjust blockade against the Cuban people. And make sure that our voices to be even louder than ever before. And so you must know the Cuban people that we stand in absolute solidarity with you, the Cuban people, and the Cuban Revolution. Que viva Fidel. Que viva the Revolution in Spanish.
The world against the U.S. blockade of Cuba.
Radio Havana, Cuba. Thanks for joining us, making Radio Havana, Cuba part of your weekend. Starting with the weekend here. Alan Yaffe is a lecturer in economic and social history at the University of Boston. She's an economic historian specializing in Cuba and Latin America. Let's listen now to a fragment of an interview with Alan Yaffe on the BBC, Helms Burkhardt, and the application of Title III of the Helms Burkhardt to strengthen the Communist Party.
However, one of the peculiar and new elements of the Title III, which has been a theme speaking for 23 years, is that it gives the status of U.S. citizens to people who were, in fact, just Cuban citizens at the time that their property was nationalized. Hotels is any company that's trafficking in it means basically that any company that sends it from and it's not just Europe, it is in fact extraterritory in the whole world, so any company as well. The European Union, as you said, has declared this to be negative violation of the law. But so has Canada, so has Mexico, and many countries have taken out the United Nations has been clear when the conference has been implemented in 1996, which is a violation of international law, and urged member states to start blocking and claw back legislation, which is exactly what the United States did in 1996. However, the EU sat down with the United States in 1997, they came up with an agreement which was reinforced in 1996. Where the U.S. agreed to continue to suspend this type of legislation. Every 6 months, the president has since then continued to suspend this type of trade. And now what has happened under the EU and kind of
has continued to vote in favor of the non-binding resolution to end the U.S. blockade of Cuba every year since 1992.
Group of 77 in China would like to reiterate our call for the economic, commercial, and financial embargo by the U.S. against Cuba to see the urgency and necessity of our call before the highlighted by the ongoing global collective drive to implement the 2018 of sustainable development. Group of 77 China, therefore, to appeal to the international community to further step up efforts in support for the lifting of the embargo, not only for the prospect of Cuba alone, but also for the full achievement of economic social development of all members of the global community and
the world. The world against the U.S. blockade of Cuba.
Radio has an archaeological announcement. Lena will be there, your host, inviting you to stay with me for the next 10 minutes or so. Today we bring a special program focused on two important events that took place earlier this week in Cuba. Stay tuned.